turned that way the whole time because there's another deer coming in. I can hear it somewhere. But he kept on creeping and creeping. Had the wind perfect going that way, blowing out of southeast. And he continues to eat, and I just poke my head out. Get my eyes right here. And he's looking at me like I'm freaking out. I cannot do nothing. And then he turned his head back and starts eating. When I draw back up and he sees me, didn't do nothing. I put it right behind his shoulder and I'm pretty sure he went down. I'm pretty sure he went like 30 yards and went down. Oh my God, did that just freaking happen? Did that just happen? I'm setting my blind up for him and he comes out. Shooting a Scott Advantage, hinge release, back tension, hunting with it. And it has made me more confident in my archery ever since I started this than any release that I've ever shot in my entire life. I don't have a face mask on, no gloves. Only thing I have working for right now was this cover and the wind blowing out of the southeast. I just shot the biggest buck of my life. I just possibly killed the biggest buck of my life. I've been scouting since summer, since early velvet. When I first got pictures of him, he was already a big boy. And it is October the 13th, Wednesday. I got off work early. I wasn't supposed to, but I got off work early because we were done doing everything. Guys, I just shot my biggest buck of my life, the Big Daddy 10.
Go.
Well, here he is, folks. Buck I've been after since this summer. First got pictures of him in April when he was in velvet. He was bigger than the rest of the bucks, and I was like, that's the buck I want to go after this season. And I followed him all the way up until he lost his velvet. Back when he was in velvet, we had a cool encounter a bunch of times. One time when I was filling feeder, and then I went to the back of it to make a mock scrape, and I look up and he's coming down the same trail that I am, and I have all this on video, and he's coming in, and he comes in to see me and just kind of leaps off and goes to the front of the property, and I'm like, well, I need to get out of here before I bust him any better, you know? And I go up there, and he's sitting there eating.
Somebody needs to get out of the light.
Sitting there browsing.
That runs the whole thing.
And he just looks at me and just kind of trots off a little bit and goes in the trail in front of me and then goes and beds down underneath the tree. And he watches me as I video him and get out of there. And then he just on camera all throughout the summer up to the fall until he sheds his velvet. Last picture I had of him was the 26th of September up in the front of the property. And then I had him on there right after deer season. And then Sunday, I was walking in about 5:50, 5:52 in the morning. And he was there 10 yards from me when I was about 20 yards from my tripod. Well, that morning about 8 o'clock, my tripod ringed around where you put your feet at, broke, and I fell down probably about 9 feet, hurt my wrist, hurt my arm, and I thought to myself I wasn't going to be able to pull my bow back for about a month. And we went and iced it and cleaned it up. And later that day, I said, I'm going to go try to shoot my bow. And if I can shoot my bow, I'm going to go hunting. And I shot 3 good arrows and bullseye. And I went hunting and never seen him. And then today, I wasn't supposed to get off to work till 6 o'clock. And my assistant manager was like, go home. We got it. They had to tell me twice on that one. Sped home, got my camo, got my bow, everything. Went out there, got some corn. I filled the feeder up with corn in one bag. I was gonna take my blind and set it probably about 20, 25 yards away from it. And as I was setting my blind up, putting the sticks in the ground, he walks in and goes straight to the feeder. I'm like, this buck is crazy. And I was like, you're gonna get it right now. And I went to back to the behind the blind where I was, and crouched down and got ready and got all the way to the edge of the blind where there's some mesquites. And I looked over and I hit a branch and he looked right at me. And then I said, please turn your head and start eating again. And that's what he did. And then I stepped out in the open and I did that and crunch. And he looked exactly right at me. I drew my bow back, let the trigger go off by itself, and he ran 30 yards and died. It's a good story to the end right there. That's how it should be.